welcome to my new series answering your questions on Tudor fiction, TV and movies. Now, I asked you to send in video selfies asking me questions, and I've had some wonderful submissions, which I will be answering over the next few weeks. Now, today I'm just going to handle one question, and a big thank you to Annette from Michigan for today's wonderful question. I do love the cat clock in the background of her video. I'm very envious of it.
Hi, Claire. Annette here from Kalamazoo, Michigan. I have a question about Charles Brandon, and particularly about an incident in his life that is depicted in The Tudors, and whether that is historically accurate. In the last season of The Tudors, we see that near the end of his life, Charles Brandon takes a mistress. And this is a French woman who he captured as a prisoner of war in the Battle of Boulogne. And then she falls in love with him and he brings her back to England with him. I'm wondering, is it true that Charles Brandon did take a mistress late in his life? Was she a French woman? And if so, do you know anything about how they met? Thank you for answering my question.
In the Tudor series, in season 4, Charles Brandon, Duke of Suffolk, King Henry VIII's best friend, played by Henry Cavill, be still my beating heart, is serving in the King's French campaign in 1544 in Boulogne when he meets Brigitte Rousselot, played by Selma Brooke. Brigitte has dressed up as a man so that she can fight against the English with her father. In a French ambush of the English troops, Suffolk wounds Brigitte's father and takes him and Brigitte captive, where Brigitte is found to be a woman. During her time as his captive, Suffolk treats Brigitte well, and despite her feelings about the English and the English king, a man, she says, the French call the English Nero, she becomes close to Suffolk. Suffolk secretly releases her father, and then he sleeps with Brigitte. On his return to England, he takes Brigitte with him, and she becomes his official mistress. Suffolk is at the time estranged from his wife, Catherine Willoughby. Madge is just checking that I'm getting all of this correct. And he becomes closer and closer to Brigitte. In 1545, Brigitte cares for Suffolk as his health declines, and she's with him when he dies. I think she even closes the eyes of his dead body. The two appear to be very much in love, and Suffolk leaves her well provided for. Now, this is a great storyline, a real love story. But is it true? Did Brigitte exist? Did Suffolk have a mistress in his final years? And was he estranged from Catherine Willoughby? Well, even though Suffolk's health was declining in the 1540s, he did, at the age of about 60, go to France in 1544, where he did command troops and he led the siege of Boulogne, capturing the town. That much is true. However, the character of Brigitte Rousselot is entirely fictional, and there is no suggestion at all that Suffolk took a French mistress or that he had any kind of estrangement from his wife, Catherine. He'd been married to Catherine since the 7th of September 1533, and the couple had two sons, Henry and Charles. There was over 30 years between Suffolk and Catherine, but the marriage appears to have been a happy one. There's no hint of any unhappiness. Despite Suffolk being a religious conservative and Catherine being a zealous reformer. Catherine was a member of a circle of evangelicals, reformers, with Queen Catherine Parr at court. And back at home in Lincolnshire, she employed reformers in her household, without, it seems, causing her husband any problems. Suffolk died at Guildford on the 22nd of August 1545. It's not known what caused his death, and he was actually just about to lead troops to Boulogne once again. The couple's sons sadly died of sweating sickness in July 1551. And about 7 years after Suffolk's death, Catherine married her gentleman usher, Richard Bertie, and went on to have two children with him. Now, a little bit of trivia for you. Although Brigitte never called Henry VIII an English Nero, because Brigitte didn't actually exist, others did call him that. During the Pilgrimage of Grace rebellion in late 1536, a priest described the king as a tyrant more cruel than Nero, for Nero destroyed but part of Rome, but this tyrant destroyeth this whole realm. And reformer Philip Melanchthon called him the English Nero. I'll share links in the description for videos that I've done on Charles Brandon, Duke of Suffolk, and his wife Catherine, so you can find out more about them, their lives, their marriage, their careers. An interesting couple. But yes, sadly, that whole storyline is rather fictional. Sad, but true. Thanks so much, Annette, for such a great question. I'll be doing more answers to your questions over the next few weeks, so do keep your eyes peeled for those. You can subscribe to the channel by clicking around about there. You can hit the bell to be notified as these videos go live, and you can give me a like and leave me a comment. I'll see you very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.